see far from a distance. They're close.
And then suddenly after they lost it,
yeah, it sounds like
it's Africa.
By a donkey.
Yeah,
that's the male.
She has the little overnight accommodation chalets.
Alright, Adrian. Signing his life away here, the walk with the lions. Done her sign. She's already survived once.
Just mind electric fence, the top one, which is this one here.
Enrichment team coming?
Yes.
Just mind electric. Whenever they're 2 to 3 years, this is when the father will chest them out of the pride. Do you know why? Taking his semen, put it on the female. That's where we noticed that he...
Because the vet which did artificial insemination on them, she, her name, she's Isabel, then his husband is Victor. That's why they were
seen in the nature. Because there's some white stones. If they were albino, they were good. By now they could be dead.
So she looks bigger, like she was the first one to be born, but it's all about genetics.
Bigger. Another male will come and challenge their father. The reason why he come to challenge, because the female will be on estrus, so he cannot mate with it. The older they get, the weak they can become. So if they same again. We love America.
Then after, we'll be going to the conservation center. Then build this conservation center for a reason, because some of other animals are in danger, are going endangered. So that's why we were to do artificial insemination on the live
animals
for the future use. These sperms, they're still gonna
work. And the vet will be always checking to see if they is about awake, so you can get him not becoming endangered. And the blue lights you see is to keep the. A lot of them, even sheep.
Got spot on the legs and on the.
And they're still little.
Spot on the muzzle. So, cheetah is the only cat species which can make pairing. And you can see they've got semi retractable claws.
Yeah, in pairing, like that. If you turn like that, just give him a space.
Okay, if you are comfortable, you can also give him your hands to lick. Outside of your hand, like
yeah, can you go behind? Yeah, can you go behind?
I got some sweat on me.
Dean.
Also, the roof is very low, so not picking them up. Whenever you approach them, just go slowly, slowly, and you can, sometimes they get scared.
You can see the baby lion cubs. It's really a build-up today, all to the do the walk with the lions, where we've seen, learned a lot about the conservation of this place here in South Africa, and lots of different cats. But now here's some lion cubs we get to spend a little time with.
Tap them on the nose.
Simba.
Yeah. Wow. From the little cubs time, now the big time walking with the lions coming next up. So as we approach the time to walk lions, we have several handlers now with us. George, Simi, Blessing have joined us. We hope to see you walk with the lions. Huh?
Hand. If you feel a little bit uncomfortable around the lion, just remember to put the stick in front of you like this. It's going to be a barrier. Okay, they'll never come to you. And second, you do not isolate yourself from the group and stand alone. We're always together in one unit. Okay, another important rule is the distance between us and the lions. So basically where you're standing, the lions are going to be somewhere here walking in front. So here just to them, we're going to be forming one pride. So you're going to be part of the pride lion. Okay,
Aswan.
Okay.
Zoro,
come. There you
come. Oh. Put Zoro there.
Oh. Nice Six catch. Years.
So the one that you walked with, they are brothers.
Okay.
Oh. Yes.
I think he may have been with his brother. I think they
were. Milo.
Yes.
Yeah.
This is Milo and
Yes. This one is
Milo.
I think the one on the photo was Hip Hop. The one that was hugging a tree.
Okay.
Yes, that's Hip Hop. So you're welcome to ask questions. You mustn't make it a silent walk. And
it's easy for the two boys to challenge a male in that pride.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. They've got a very good unified relationship.
So these are, they are now in the prime age, 6 years, but they're only fully grown at 7 years. That's when they're going to be considered fully grown at 7 years. They are constantly eager to scent mark their ranges to mark the territory. So you can see the way they are walking, very gentle. But you might think maybe they are snoozing. They are very much alert with nature. If ever told they see anything in front in terms of a prey, they go for it. They have killed a lot of animals on the walks like this, from impalas, blessbox, and zebras. Okay, move, 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 move. So the only way once they retire, you must have seen their shadow and Jack Daniels on the other side.
Yeah.
They retired some 2 years ago. So we haven't really found them any mate yet. Good boy. Nice. They lost a mate.
Boy.
Nice. They lost a mate. No, poetry. Okay, let's carry on again.
Thank you for Michaela.
So why are we walking with the lions only? Why can't we walk with tigers, jaguars? They've got 8 times eyesight than us. What we can see far from a distance, they can see through that 8 times and use the binocular vision. Never we can let go of that food as long as it has been gripped by the claws.
Do they know how many chickens they get so when it's
not really
gonna be over? No, they still think there could be more.
These small little snacks, it's not even like 2 kgs, so
yeah.
Less than maybe 500 gram, maybe 600 grams.
Mm. He didn't want to
but on a normal feed, he can consume up to about 15 chickens, big ones, for himself. Because these are small little snacks, they keep on fighting about it, you know, trying to work very hard for it. Okay, so we shall be taking some small little videos. Come on. Come on.
Come on.
Same drill. Why do you think they use them for? Whenever they are bringing down the prey, down, there's so much pressure going down, so it's going to be acting as a cushion, not to hurt the harbour. The mommy should lower the tail according to the height of the baby. It's going to be acting as a GPS. And also, whenever they are walking into the tall grass, they lift up the tail, they'll be GPSing one another. See, the higher the testosterone level in a male lion, the bigger the mane it becomes, very dark and very pronounced. Mm-hmm. Because they are mating. Like now, the mane is not fully grown, rather not compacted. Gets to be attracted to the male with a bigger mane because they know that they have got high testosterone levels in them. And they can also protect them if there's any other arrivals that might maybe invade into their territories. They know that this man with a bigger, dark man we can trust as females. Uh-huh. Because if the male is losing the man in a pride, in a normal pride, where they use as extra color to blend in, especially when the grass in summer, when it's all brown and barren, they are able to blend in and hunt nicely. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Thank you.
Didn't need
Thank
to you. Use it.
You see?
That's good.
Very good, eh?
Awesome. Thank you very much.